These are the remains of my old lab, or workshop, or however you want to call it, in which I spent the last 6 years creating electronics videos for my YouTube channel. And that will not change. I will still continue creating new videos. But as you can see, from now on inside this new lab, plus a small workshop next door. I've been working on these rooms for over half a year now, and implemented all ideas and knowledge I gathered from making electronics projects for almost a decade. This way, working in these rooms should be as pleasant and efficient as possible. Which is why today I want to share with you how exactly I did it, in case you might be looking for some upgrades for your own workstation or similar. So let's not waste any more time and let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, who can do it all. And by that I mean not only schematic and PCB design, along with of course PCB production and PCB assembly, but also 3D printing and even CNC machining. Their industrial 3D printing starts from $1, and even their CNC prices are also affordable. And best of all, due to their flexible manufacturing, automated production and intelligent warehouse, they can easily meet customer demands for small batch production prototypes, while still delivering high quality parts that you can get quickly. So check them out. Now first off, since the topic of setting up a lab is rather huge, let's split it into lighting, workbenches, storage and finally other stuff, which in total should hopefully cover everything. So let's start simple with lighting. And for that, I so far used such a ceiling mounted lamp with GU10 LED bulbs. So nothing special. What I didn't really like about it was that A, it was not dimmable, and B, all the light beams obviously come from one source. To improve on that, I this time decided on such LED spots that you can easily get from the internet. And by the way, every product or 3D model I mention in this video will be linked in the video description. But anyway, the awesome thing about these spots is that you can not only set their color temperature by flipping a switch, but they can also easily get dimmed without any flickering by using a suitable dimmer. So as soon as I got the layout for my future lab, I determined suitable locations for 6 spots. Created cutouts for them in the drywall ceiling, pulled the wire through and wired everything up in small distribution boxes. And in case you're wondering, yes, I'm working with 230 volts AC mains voltage here, which you should not do if you're not a professional. Okay, and after then installing the dimmer, my lighting setup was complete and illuminated the room way more evenly than before. And to bring this lighting topic to the end, let me tell you that for recording videos, I still use my aperture video light, as well as my permanently mounted warm white LED strip on my workbench, that I can also dim. And speaking of workbenches, let's continue with that topic. Now I honestly think that a workbench is the most important thing in a good lab or workshop. And I gotta say that after 6 years of using mine, there is not a single thing I would change about them. All you have to do to make your own is simply cutting some wood lamps to size, paint them with walnut colored wood stain, secure them to the wall with some wall plugs and big screws at a height of around 70 cm, which is in my opinion the perfect height for a workbench that you can sit at, and then put your workbenches on top and secure them with extra feet and some angle brackets. Pretty straightforward stuff, but if you crave more details, then feel free to check out my garage video in which I built several of them. Now probably the last thing to mention about my specific workbenches is that I had to shorten them by 20 cm due to my new lab layout. But that was definitely worth it, because now I can move around one part of it and thus shoot with new angles for videos. Sweet! And in case you're wondering when I'm going to talk about what tools and components to have in such a lab, then let me tell you that this video is more about efficient organization. But feel free to check out two of my previous videos to learn about that. And with that being said, we finally come to the mother of all topics, storage. And here I have a lot to tell you and recommend. So let's simply start off with my wall-mounted storage cabinets, in which I host most of my electronics components. Now at first sight, there really was nothing wrong with them, and they did their job just fine. But over time, I started to dislike their look on camera. The bins attracted too much dust, and I wanted to implement a new, simpler sorting system for quite a while. And for that, I needed a fresh start. And that was the moment I found this modular shelving system on printables, which looked incredible and is highly customizable. So next, more or less as an impulse, I simply started printing with all my 3D printers. And just for reference, one small bin took around 1.5 hours to print, while one bigger cabinet piece took around 8 hours. And I needed quite a few of them to get one complete cabinet. I actually did the math, and by using one printer, it would equal around 78 hours of printing and 1.6 kg of filament. Oh boy. But after using the connector pieces that came with the model to create the final cabinets and then inserting all the bins, I gotta say that I was super happy with the end results. And because I was in too deep at this point anyway, I obviously had to 3D print a ton more in order to ultimately create 6 of them, that you can also once again connect together. So next, I sorted my components from the old bins into the new ones. And the simplified sorting system I was talking about earlier simply got rid of part numbers, and instead replaced them with the general term of the component group. And I know that this makes it a bit harder to, for example, find the one specific MOSFET you're looking for. But trust me, in 99% of the cases, pretty much any MOSFET will do. And that of course correlates with most other components. Only when it is really important to differentiate between them, I sorted them this way. And in case you're wondering, I made the labels by using the given files for the model and then simply adding lettering on top with another filament color. This worked wonderfully with my Bamboo Lab 3D printer, and I was really happy as soon as everything finally came together. And last but not least, all that was left to print were the wall mounts for it, which did their job just fine in the new lab, after of course once again drilling holes, adding wall plugs and screws. So yeah, this was definitely one exhausting to make storage highlight for me. But what was not that exhausting to make, but still super useful, were these two big shelves. You see, in my old lab I had this big open heavy duty shelf that held most of the stuff I needed in my lab. Only problem was that due to its open nature, it always looked messy and attracted dust. So in order to fix that, I searched online and found a manufacturer that offers customizable shelf solutions. By the way, this is not sponsored or anything, but after building up the shelves, I gotta say that the price performance ratio was pretty good, even though there were some scratches and imperfections, and the drawer system does not work perfectly all the time. But all in all, I was rather happy with them. And the great thing is that most of the stuff from my old heavy duty shelf fit inside it, as well as pretty much all of the electrical components from my IKEA drawers. Yes, this thing offers tons of space and keeps the mess hidden behind doors. Combine that with a label maker and you got yourself a lovely organized system that I can highly recommend. And pretty much only my IKEA drawers on wheels are still in my new lab like they were in my old lab, because they're just awesome to move tools around easily. And do not worry, I didn't throw any old stuff into the garbage, because not only did my IKEA drawers got a second life in my garage along with my heavy duty shelf, but also my old wall cabinets, so that they can store everything big and mechanical that I no longer have to store in my lab. That also includes my tool wall, for which I got myself a replacement in the form of 3 pegboards, that I also got from IKEA. I don't know, they just offer cool storage solutions. But anyway, after hanging them up, I once again browsed through printables to find things to 3D print for it. And there were certainly a ton. I decided on this small selection here, and with the help of it, I was able to position my most important tools right next to my workbench. And in case you didn't notice yet, right above the pegboards, I also mounted a 3D printer filament storage rack that also seems to work beautifully. And I think that actually covers most of my storage solutions. Which brings me to the last other topic. And here all I want to mention is that a dual monitor setup like this is awesome for work, and having a whiteboard around is always helpful. And last but not least, if you have the chance, like finally me, then always separate your electrical from your mechanical work. Because having to work on woods or metal in your lab is just a mess. And with that being said, these were all my tips and suggestions for good lab or workshop. And now I'm excited to hear what you think about mine in the comment section. And honestly speaking, this moving process took forever, was quite exhausting, and it still feels like there are dozens of things left to do. But so far, I'm happy that I can now continue with my usual video production. And I hope you're looking forward to more videos. Until then, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!